Carl, what's up? How y'all doing? Talk to me. How y'all feel today? How y'all feeling? Guy, I want to hope that he can come in with me. Some real stuff.
There it is.
Andy, what's up, baby? How you doing?
Cooling, man. Cooling.
Talk to
man.
Me, man. Doing? Talk to me.
Man. You want to pray in real quick?
Huh?
You want to pray it in real quick?
Yeah, pray it in real quick. Lord God, we just want to thank you for this moment and this time, Lord, that you made available to us, Lord. Let us hope. Be able to glorify your name in this time, Lord. We pray for those who are losing people, Lord. We just pray that you cover them, Lord. Give them the peace and the desire that we need for eternal life, Lord. We thank you. We want to praise all these things in Jesus' name. Andy. Now, my man Andy, I thought my man Andy had something going on. Just one second. Let me see if I can get him back. I don't know what happened. What happened, brother?
Kyle, devil hating, prince of powers of the air, you know?
Yeah, bro. So how you holding up and everything?
Man, everything's good, bro. We've been doing the drive-in church, you know what I mean? Like a drive-through, people pulling up, honoring the social distancing, you know what I'm saying? Everybody remaining in their cars, bro. Words going forward with power, though, man. We're in some interesting times right now, you know what I mean?
What do you think about this time right now?
Well, you know, just reading in the Word, you know, this is the beginning of sorrows. You know, right now it's time for people to get right, you know what I'm saying, to get under the blood covenant. Because one thing we got to understand, when Passover came and they put the blood of the lamb over the doorpost, the death angel had to pass over, right? So if the blood of the lamb made the death angel pass over, Corona ain't got no chance against the blood of Jesus Christ. You know, so right now it's time for people to get under the blood. Like, everything happens for a reason. There's no such thing as coincidences. You know what I mean?
I was reading in the Word that sometimes, like, a pestilence or, like, a famine will hit the earth so just so the God can direct his hand here to let him know that there is a God in this part. But, like, during this time, you know, just the beginning of sorrows, when you say that, what you mean by the beginning of sorrows?
So in the disciples in the book of Matthew, whenever Jesus had first came through, right, after Lent, you know, after they came through and he was telling them, Hosanna, Hosanna. Well, after that, the disciples, he was on the mountain, right? So he showed them, the disciples were showing him the synagogues. And it was like saying, like, look how beautiful the synagogues are. And Jesus said, there's going to be a time when these buildings are not going to be standing, when there's not going to be a brick left upon a brick. And he was trying to get them focused on, look, don't get caught up on the building because my kingdom I want to establish inside of you. You know what I'm saying? Like, we are the church. So if you look at right now, all the churches are shut down because God is looking. Revelations, it said, well, when they fall away, when they backslid, he said, return back to your first works. They was preaching before they had buildings. You know what I mean? Jesus ain't had no sound system and speakers and all of that. We done got spurred with all of that, you know? So whenever they came to him and he told them, he was like, look, there's going to be a time when these buildings ain't left standing. Right now, if you look, it's not about your Catholic building. It's not about your Baptist building. It's not about your Pentecostal building. It's about your relationship with God. It's about you building the kingdom of God inside of you. You know what I mean? So, and I know a lot of people are not going to like to hear that, but that's why I said don't be a mad Christian. Your doctrine, God ain't called your doctrine. God called you to have a relationship with him, you know what I mean? With the undefiled doctrine that's in the Word of God. So when they asked him, when he told them that, they said, when's all of this going to happen? He said, when the time's approaching, there's going to be wars and rumors of war, kingdoms against kingdoms. And he said, it's going to have earthquakes. We got the earthquakes right now. They're going to have locusts. We got the locusts right now. And he said, it's going to have pestilence on the land. We got the pandemic right now. And he said, in this will be the beginning of sorrows. You know what I'm saying? So if, you know, you know me, but if anybody in here, like, But I preached a message called Kingdom Vision 2020, right? It said, remain still during testing, looking at an object that's stationary. That means we got to be still, know he's God in the middle of this test, but we got to have our eyes on Christ and know that he's still on the throne. He's still the Father. He's still in control. Corona ain't surprised him. So I said, before the second coming, God loves his people too much to just come back, because the Father's wish is that none shall perish, right? If his wish is that none shall perish, before the second coming, he's gonna reveal his power to his people. He's gonna give people an opportunity to repent from their sins. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you look, the clubs are shut. Like, I'm in New Orleans right now. Bourbon Street ain't never been shut down for nothing. You know what I'm saying? It looks like a ghost town, right? I said there's going to be a revival hitting you all. It's so great that the clubs are going to be shut down. Look out there in New York, man. You ain't never see it empty like that. God is giving people an opportunity. He's removing all of the distractions. He was removing all the obstacles, and he's getting the people to go right back in the presence of God. Like, now it's time. I removed every distraction. You was too busy for me because you had too much work. You was too busy for me because you was in the entertainment field. You was too busy for me because you was in this. So let me remove all these distractions. Now what's your excuse? It's time to get in the presence of God. And when you get in the presence of God and he reveals himself to you, that's when you repent, because without repentance, there's no remission of sins. So in order to be forgiven of your sin, like, well, you know, when cancer goes into remission, you can't even detect it. It's like you never had it. That's when your sins go into remission. It's like you've never even did them. You know what I'm saying? Love holds no record of wrongdoing. God is love. God's not up there with a tablet writing down every time that you committed a sin, because once you get under the blood covenant, he washes those sins away. Now, whatever you do after that, when you're in sin, he's a just God and he has to judge sin. He ain't no crooked judge. Come on, somebody, look.
So,
you know,
So when you say the remission of sins, and you go and you repent for your sins, you go in, like the repentance part, right? Is that repentance part one time thing? Do God carry on a plan for you right after that time that you repent?
Now, see, and that's the thing. Well, see, repentance is like sanctification, right? That's an ongoing process until you die, because we still got this flesh on us, right? So if we fall, we got to repent. You know what I'm saying? So all right, you gave your life to Christ. You repented. You truly asked yourself. From that moment on, you're under the blood, and he's not holding record of everything you did in the past. It's like everything's brand new, right? But then you proceed to live life, and you fall again. You know what I'm saying? You proceed to live life, and you fall again. You got to repent again, because he's rich in mercy. His grace is sufficient, right? He gives you grace for each day. So that's the thing. Like, right now in this season, you don't want to get caught playing with sin. You know what I'm saying? There got to be some repentance. And repentance in the Hebrew means you change your mind. So if you're constantly doing the same thing over and over, you never really change your mind.